The hills of Tuscany are green to the south, but here in Imola, the air is red hot. Welcome to Ferrari's turf for the Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix. The track has been around since the 60s, but the first official Formula One race was held here in 1980. Let's see what excitement lies ahead this year. This is Imola, and it's an old school track with plenty of elevation changes and lots of corners. There's only one DRS zone here, but it follows the long straight right before Tamburello and should see plenty of action. At this early stage in the season, there are still plenty of opportunities for things to change. In this sport, there simply are no guarantees. There's nothing like a race weekend in Formula One.
Radio check.
Radio check. Keep us updated.
I really struggle to just couldn't go any faster.
Okay, understood.
Copy, Joe.
Any suggestion we keep out of box?
We can take a look now. So let's look at this. There's Sergio Perez. Goodness me, they're completely off the racing line.
Oh.
And that was a... Someone's run wide.
Yellow ahead.
Copy.
Radio check.
Copy.
Oh, did someone run wide there? Let's have a look. Let's have a look here. This was the Aston Martin. They're forced wide, and they won't be happy at all about that. That's going to be a... We've had a crash. Here's the replay. All eyes on Kevin Magnussen here. There's the crash. Just had a crash on the track. Let's take a look at the replay. Right, watch this. There's Schumacher. And there.
Focus.
Cop.
Let's see what happened there. Now let's watch this. The Alfa Romeo involved in this one. And this, yes, there, that's the lockup. The team are really disappointed with that. Let's hope it doesn't set them back too badly. We can take a look now. Let's have another look. Science is the focus here. Oh, another.
Keep us updated.
Our race weekend continues as we head into FP3 and then qualifying. Yesterday's action gave us a fantastic taste of what is to come, and the anticipation within the paddock continues to grow. Qualifying promises to be as unrelenting as ever. Only the best, the most consistent drivers can progress from one period to the next and stand a chance of earning a place at the front of the grid. Here we go, folks. It's time to get started.
Radio check.
Radio check.
Yellow head.
Let's take a closer look. Daniel Ricciardo involved here. A definite.
Struggling with grip.
Copy.
Someone's run wide. Let's take a look at the replay. Now we see Valtteri Bottas. They go. Thank you.
Radio check.
Copy.
So there's rain.
Copy.
All clear.
Copy.
Radio check.
Was that a lock-up on the track? Here's the replay. Now have a watch of this. Looks like Ocon. Well, they've lost it. They've locked up.
Radio check.
Radio check.
Drivers are strapping themselves in, ready for race day.
Alfa Romeo managed to meet expectations during qualifying, and if they can keep this up, they'll have a good race ahead of them. We saw a reasonable push from Mercedes in qualifying, and they'll have plenty of opportunities here to achieve a great result. And the race will be taking place under blue skies. That means the teams should be able to apply their strategies without any added complications.
And seeing it all come together is sure to be a thrill. An exciting race ahead for us here at the Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix. As the sun continues to shine, it seems like nothing can dampen the mood of excitement here at the track. And there's Valtteri Bottas. A top 10 position today, but will they be able to capitalize on it? And there's Joe, down the grid. With a top 10 position on the grid, this race could really go either way for them. Will their hard work pay off today? The crowd are on their feet in anticipation of this, the Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix. And it's lights out, and away we go.
Push.
Copy.
Looks like that was a position gained for ALFA ROMEO.
DRS enabled. No overtake.
Copy.
Is that a lockup? Let's have a look. Now have a watch of this. Looks like Ocon. It's a lockup, and that could be costly. And the team had such high hopes today. What a shame. I think someone's run wide. Let's see what happened there. Now let's look at this, the focus on Tsunoda. Goodness me, they're completely off the racing line. The team are devastated. They'll be questioning just what happened out there.
No more overtake.
Copy.
They crashed out. We can take a look now. Now we see Valtteri Bottas. That crash is terrible news for the team. And that was a bitter blow for the team. And it may have really hurt their overall chances.
Thank you.
A position gained for Alfa Romeo. That's a good overtake from Alpine. Oh, did someone run wide there? Let's take a look at the replay. Now look at this, it was the Alpha team. I think that was a crash. Let's take a closer look. Now we see Valtteri Bottas. Clearly something went very, very wrong there. We've just had a car run wide. Someone's run wide. I think we've had a car run wide. Who's running wide there? Alfa Romeo just moved up a place. Oh, and that's a crash. Let's have a look. Watch this. There's Leclerc. Oh, Sounds like someone's gone wide there. Sounds like someone's locked up. There's been a crash. Sounds like a single car. Let's see what happened there. Daniel Ricciardo involved here. Seems to have been a lockup. Alpine just advanced. And Sainz crosses the line first. He's taken the win. A phenomenal conclusion to the weekend for Joe. Really great finish there for Alfa Romeo.
This was thrilling to watch. They've done an excellent job and they deserve all the plaudits.
And after this result, the team is fourth in the constructor standings.
Coming up next, the teams will be taking a finish.